picture this. It is a beautiful day, but your allergies are making you miserable.
So you find a remedy that's been in the medicine cabinet longer than the expiration date.
Is it safe to take, or do you spend the money for a new prescription? Well, in tonight's cover story, experts give us an expiration explanation. They're found on every bottle in every pharmacy, but what do they really mean? We're talking about the numbers that make up the expiration date on every bottle of prescription medication.
The expiration dates were actually instituted by the FDA in about 1975, and they asked the drug makers to actually come up with a system to guarantee the safety and the potency of drugs past a certain point or up to a certain point.
But some states took it a step further.
In Maryland, when a pharmacist dispenses a medication to a patient, the pharmacist must put an expiration date of 1 year from the date of dispensing, or less if the manufacturer's container says it's going to expire.
In Maryland and several other states, those numbers on the side of the bottle are essentially a use-by date, not an expiration date.
So even if a manufacturer's container that the pharmacist gets the drug out of says that the drug is going to expire in 5 years, a pharmacist still has to put a 1 year expiration date on that.
Even if a drug is past the manufacturer's expiration date, it could still be effective. The U.S. military proved that in a study in the 1980s.
So what the U.S. Air Force did was to start testing all their drugs for stability issues and to see how long they would remain stable after the expiration date. And they found that some drugs, or most drugs actually, more than 90% of drugs will remain potent up to 3 to 15 years after their expiration date.
So as a consumer, what should you do? Our experts both agree it's better to be safe than sorry.
The FDA could set different guidelines for certain drugs, but the problem with the individual consumer is if you have your medicine cabinet and that cabinet is overflowing, the risk is that people start self-medicating.
Over the years, there's also been speculation that since the expiration dates are provided by the companies that manufacture the medications, they might just be a ploy to increase profits. But both of the experts we spoke with say that's probably not the case.
I can actually tell you that the drug companies are mostly concerned with the safety aspects.
I think the manufacturers, of course they want to make money, as we've seen over and over again. But I think they are genuinely concerned that the products that they have out there are as pure as they possibly can be. Manufacturers have a lot at stake here, including especially their reputations.
But when it comes to Maryland's strict one-year rule, Dr. Palumbo says lawmakers in Annapolis might want to take a second look.
I really do think they should take a look at it. There are many instances when people are throwing away perfectly good medications.
We asked the FDA to discuss policy on expiration dates. They never responded, however.
If you want to get the longest shelf life out of your medications, make sure you store them in a cool, dry place.
Experts we spoke to say the medicine cabinet in your bathroom with a shower in the bathtub is one of the worst places because of all that heat and humidity.